Edmund Evershot made no more reference to closing the cafe, just threw meaningful little glances around every time he came in. They were enough to make me keep polishing the chrome and titivating the displays, stopping just short of standing in the doorway and trying to force cakes on unwilling passers-by, and I wondered if he knew about my life and circumstances, the effect that his threat had on me, or whether he was just a major control freak trying to get extra hours of work out of Jules and I for no extra pay. Well, me, really. Jules hadn't given something for nothing since our school prom, and even thinking that made me feel like a bitch. So there we were, baking and serving and all business as usual. I'll have a strawberry and banana smoothie. I smiled and tried not to mutter, please, behind my teeth as I bustled to get the fruit out of the fridge and into the blender, squeezing past Julia, who was pouring boiling water into teapots. She looked up suddenly and did a wide-eyed stare, then jerked her head at me. The boss is in. I set the blender going and, under cover of getting a muffin out from the display case, I looked quickly across the tea room. The far doors were thrown wide open to the sun and breeze. Little tufted seed heads kept drifting in from the distant flower beds, and just outside, I could see Josh bringing one of the birds down for the afternoon display in the walled garden. Behind the door stood Edmund, iPad in hand, and a slight frown pulling his glasses towards the end of his nose. Right, this is worrying. I trayed up the smoothie, added a straw, and slid it along to the cash register. Why? Look how busy we are, Ames. If he wants to change all this and get rid of the cafe, he'd better have a damn good reason. Bane flew from Josh's glove, spiralled up, and then came in a low dive through the watching audience, slicing the sunlight with sudden wings to the sound of applause. I could hear Josh, through his radio mic, explaining that Bane was Alana Falcon, talking about birds of prey in general, while she hopped on the glove again.